I'm here with Ron Schmeits, NRA President Ron Schmeits, I should say. Always good to see you.
Jenny, it's always good to be here, and good to be with you.
And here we are at CPAC, and I was just talking with Joe Gregory about the changes we have seen in 1 year when it comes to the changes in the Congress and state houses of supporters for our firearm freedoms. Would you ever have guessed it that we'd be standing here talking about that today?
No, I don't think so. You know, you look at a national level, we had 90-some changes when you look at both houses, and you look at the state levels, it's between 600 and 800 when you look at the numbers out there that have changed for, you know, kind of the freedom rights of the citizens of the United States. And you look at CPAC, you know, CPAC is, has gained more national news as we go along. Mm-hmm. We've got some of the greatest individuals making presentations here. You know, we have Romney will be later on today. Donald Trump will be here. You know, so we got some people, and then we look out at the crowd. That's the future of our political system, is those young people sitting out there listening and being a part of this great function that we're at here today.
And you say a young crowd, and when you walk around and you talk to some of these students from colleges around the country, they're young, but they know the issues, and they know the importance of being involved.
Well, they do. You know, and when I look at a young crowd, I got to prepareize that just a little bit, because we have a lot of young people out there, but we have a lot of people that are aged out there, too. You know, they've been through it, they've got the experience, and they're sharing with these younger people. So I think that sharing of what's going on and exchange of ideas is really what makes this convention that they have so darn important.
What do you think the significance of CPAC is? I know that, you know, a lot of the presidential hopefuls love to come here. A lot of people say it's spring training for what's ahead. What do you think is the importance of this specific year?
Well, I think this specific year, you know, we've got to have a lot of people out there that are looking at the 2012 election. And chances are somebody that is speaking here today or tomorrow is going to be that candidate and will be the next president of the United States. And being able to firsthand hear them right here and then go back and share those ideas with your people back home and then be able to go to the polls and vote for that person, that's fantastic.
You going to make any predictions on who it is?
Early. No. You know, I think it's too early. There's a lot of great people out there. And, you know, if you look at the past elections, sometimes it's somebody that comes that we haven't been thinking about. And it may be one of the presenters here at this time that hasn't made that declaration of running for a national office like that as being president. So I think we've got some neat things happening downstairs.
And there's always some work to do, but where do you think the gun issue of the Second Amendment ranks in the issues and of importance?
Well, I think gun issue and freedom to me is somewhat the same. As I was visiting with a group earlier, you know, a gun doesn't shoot somebody. It takes the person behind it. If the gun did shoot somebody, I'm not a very good speller. Well, that's the case, they'd outlaw all pencils. Now, that's a little bit unrealistic. But let's use that same thing for gun rights. You know, it isn't the gun that does, but I think we'll see some political maneuvers towards that because of they take advantage of a disaster.
Absolutely.
And that's a terrible situation to be in.
Mm-hmm. And it's so true, because you look at what happened in Tucson, and it didn't take long for the anti-gunners to jump on that and now say, you know, we need to ban high-capacity magazines, as if that was going to really make a difference.
Well, that's true. I mean, look how many people get killed on the highway every year. We aren't going to ban automobiles. Mm-hmm. It just doesn't work that way.
But it's a debate that we expected and predicted, anybody could have predicted. But what frustrates you, angers you most, that here we go again?
Well, I think just taking advantage of a disaster, what angers me the most. I mean, everybody's out there looking for an advantage, and they think that's an advantage, and I think that's a very, very poor way to do it in our society.
But as you travel around and talk to the public, don't you think they're getting more smart to that? And realizing that it's more about keeping America and securing what makes America so special. And that's why they're in this fight.
Well, I think so. I think the American people, I look at that and I look at anybody that takes advantage of that type of disaster. You know, my feeling and my respect for them has been downgraded substantially. And I think the American people are feeling the same way. You know, I like to be upbeat and very positive. And that's the type of people I like to be around, and that's what I'm going to vote for when 2012 comes around.
I got to ask you, because you're heading into the few final months of your presidency. You look back, I'm sure, such a so many highlights. Anything really stand out?
Well, I don't know that anything particularly stands out because I really enjoy people and I enjoy being part of the groups. The thing that maybe is just most disappointing, which is probably a little easier to explain, is that I have been invited to so many places and so many functions, and you got to make decisions as which ones you need to go to. I just wish that there were more days or more hours in the week so that I could participate in more activities than what I have.
Mm-hmm. But I know one thing very important to you is hunting, getting more young people involved, protecting that tradition, that heritage we have, and a lot of work to do there because I know there's a big concern that we got to get more young people involved.
Well, we do, you know, and hunting is a type of conservation. And whether it's in the United States or anywhere in the world, you know, we need to look at protecting our wildlife. And one of the ways we do that is to make sure that our conservation efforts are correct. And hunting helps with one of those. So I'm very interested in seeing young people shoot. They just need to be exposed, mm-hmm. and we need to help them do that.
And I know that even though your presidency's winding down, you are going to be a true fighter for many more years to come.
Well, I believe in what the NRA stands for, and I believe in freedom, and I think we need to protect that here in the United States. We're the only nation, and the NRA is the only and the largest, I think, you know, freedom organization that there is in the world, mm-hmm. and we need to continue.
Challenges you see ahead?
Well, I think our first challenge, let's just look at the next 18 months and finish up in November of 2012. That's a big challenge for us.
And this is a good start standing right here, right?
It is. I mean, we got a great people here. We got 11,000 people here at this CPAC meeting, and they're all going to go back enthused, and, you know, we can see great things happen.
And that's what it's all about.
Yeah, it is.
Always good to talk to you. Thanks,
Brian. Thank you.